Hi everyone, welcome to Idea About Video Classes. In previous video, we discussed about section formula for internal division and external division, midpoint and collinear points. Today, I am going to explain some problems related to section formula, midpoint and collinear points. Now come to the statement of the given problem. Find the coordinates of the point P which divides the line joining of the points A and B internally in the ratio 1:3. Now, what is the formula for internal division? mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. Now, use that section formula on your given data. First, write down the given points. Given points are A 1, -3, B is -3, -9. Now denote this point A with x1, y1. Take this point B as x2, y2. What is the given ratio? 1:3 internally. So m:n equals to 1:3. So, from the internal division formula, coordinates of P can be taken as mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. Now, substitute the corresponding values in this formula. Now, this is equal to m value 1. x2 is -3 plus n is 3 into x1, 1 divided by m plus n, 1 plus 3, my2, m value 1 into y2 value 9 plus n value 3, y1 value -3 divided by 1 plus 3. Now this is equal to 1 into -3, -3 plus 3 into 1, 3 divided by 1 plus 3, 4. This is 1 into 9, 9 plus into -3, 3 into 3, 9 divided by 4. So therefore coordinates of P is 0, 0. So, what is your final answer? P equals to 0, 0. Now, come to the second problem. Find the coordinates of P which divides the line joining the points A 3, 4 and B is -6, 2 externally in the ratio 3:2. Now, what is the formula for external division? mx2 minus nx1 divided by m minus n, my2 minus ny1 divided by m minus n. So, apply that formula on your given data. Now here, what are the given points? 3, 4 and -6, 2. First, write down the given points. A is 3, 4, B is -6, 2. Now take this point A as x1, y1, B equals to x2, y2. What is the given ratio? 3:2. So m:n is equals to 3:2. Now formula for external division is mx2 minus nx1 divided by m minus n, my2 minus ny1 divided by m minus n. Now substitute the corresponding values in this formula. Now this is equal to m, that is 3 into x2 minus 6 minus n value 2 into x1, x1 value 3. Divided by m minus n, that is 3 minus 2, m into y2, m value 3, y2 value 2 minus n. What is the value of n? 2 into y1, y1 value 4, divided by m minus n, that is 3 minus 2. Now this is equal to 3 into minus 6 minus 18 minus 2 into 3, 6, divided by 3 minus 2, 1. 3 into 2, 6 minus 2 into 4, 8, divided by 3 minus 2, 1. So therefore, coordinates of P are x coordinate value minus 24, y coordinate value minus 2. So therefore, P equals to minus 24 comma minus 2. Now come to the third problem. Find the midpoint of line segment joining the points 1 comma 2 and 3 comma 4. Now what are the given points? 1 comma 2 and 3 comma 4. So denote the first point with A and 3 comma 4 with B. Suppose P is the midpoint of AB. Now denote the first point coordinates with x1, y1 and take the second point as x2, y2. If P is the midpoint of AB, then coordinates of P equals to x1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. So apply the midpoint form formula. Come to the solution. Let A equals to 1 comma 2, denote this point with x1, y1. B equals to 3 comma 4, it is x2 comma y2. Let P is the midpoint of AB. Let P equals to midpoint of AB. Now what is the formula for midpoint? X1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Now substitute the corresponding values. X1 plus x2 divided by 2, 1 plus 3 divided by 2. Next, y1 plus y2 divided by 2, 2 plus 4 divided by 2. Now this is equal to 1 plus 3, 4 divided by 2. It is 6 divided by 2. Therefore, P equals to 2 comma 3. So what is the final answer? Midpoint coordinates P equals to 2 comma 3. Now come to the next problem. If one end point of the diameter of a circle is 3 comma 4, and center of the circle is 2 comma 3. Find the coordinates of other end. Now here, what is the diagram in your data? Circle. First, draw a circle. Now take a circle. Suppose this is the center of the circle. A chord passing through the center is called a diameter. Now this is the diameter of the circle. Now this is the center of the circle. Now this is one end point of diameter. This is another end point of diameter. In your data, one end point of diameter is given as 3 comma 4. Suppose this point will be 3 comma 4. Next, center of the circle is 2 comma 3. So center coordinates are 2 comma 3. Find the coordinates of other end. Now this point coordinates will be required. Suppose take this point as A and the required point as B. So this B point coordinates are required. Now here, center is the equidistant from end points of diameter of the circle. So this is the radius of circle. It is also radius of the circle. It means center is the midpoint of end points of diameter. So you can apply the midpoint form formula. So what is midpoint formula? X1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Now take this point 3 comma 4 as x1, y1. We don't know coordinates of B. Take that point as suppose alpha comma beta. Now denote this point with x2 comma y2. Now from the diagram, this point C is the midpoint of AB. Now come to the solution. Let A equals to 3 comma 4. This is x1, y1. B equals to alpha comma beta. This is equal to x2 comma y2. B the other end of diameter. Other end of diameter. Now center coordinates C equals to 2 comma 3. Now from the diagram, C is the midpoint of AB. C equals to midpoint of AB. Now C point coordinates are 2 comma 3. Midpoint formula x1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Now this is equal to x1, that is 3, x2 value alpha. So 3 plus alpha divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2, 4 plus beta divided by 2. Now LHS 2 comma 3. Now equating the x coordinates, that is 2 equals to 3 plus alpha divided by 2. Then equating the y coordinates also, 3 equal to 4 plus beta divided by 2. So 2 into 2, 4 equal to 3 plus alpha. Alpha is 1. Here 2 into 3, 6 equal to 4 plus beta. Bring this 4 from RHS to LHS. So this is beta equals to 2. So therefore, other end point of diameter, other end point of diameter equals to, what is the point coordinates? Alpha comma beta. Alpha value 1, beta value 2. Now come to the next problem. Show that the points 1 comma minus 1, 5 comma 2 and 9 comma 5 are collinear. Now how to prove these three points are collinear points? To prove these three points are collinear, it is enough to prove sum of the lengths of any two segments equals to other segments. Sum of lengths of any two segments is equal to other segment. Now come to the solution. First denote the given points as A, B and C. Let A equals to 1 comma minus 1, B equals to 5 comma 2, C equal to 9 comma 5. Now first calculate the distance between the points AB, then distance between the points B and C, then distance between the points A and C. First AB value is distance between the two points. What is the formula for distance between two points? Square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. in general square root of difference of x coordinates whole square plus difference of y coordinates whole square. Now this equal to square root of difference of x coordinates whole square, that is 5 minus 1 whole square plus difference of y coordinates whole square, that is a 2 minus of minus 1 whole square. Now this equal to square root of 5 minus 1, 4. So 4 square, this is 2 minus of minus 1, 2 plus 1, 3. 3 square. It is root of 16 plus 9. Root 25, it will be 5. Then calculate the value of BC. Distance between the points B and C is denoted by product BC equals to square root of difference of x coordinates whole square plus difference of y coordinates whole square, 9 minus 5 whole square plus 5 minus 2 whole square is equal to square root of 9 minus 5, it is 4 square plus 5 minus 2, 3. So 3 square equals to square root of 16 plus 9, root of 25, it is 5. Then calculate the value of AC, distance between the points A and C. This is equal to square root of, again, difference of x coordinates whole square plus difference of y coordinates whole square. It is 9 minus 1 whole square plus 5 minus of minus 1, that is 5 plus 1 whole square. See, the square root of 9 minus 1, 8. So 8 square, 5 plus 1, 6. 6 square. This is square root of 8 square, 64, plus 6 square, 36. So square root of 100, it will be 10. AB value 5, BC value 5, and AC value 10. Now see the relation between AB, BC and AC. Now clearly AB plus BC equal to AC. Now see the diagram. This is the point A, this is the point B, this is the point C. AB plus BC equal to AC. Sum of the lengths of any two segments is equal to third segment. So these three points are said to be collinear points. So hence the points ABC are collinear. Now come to the next point. X-axis divides line joining the points AX1Y1, BX2Y2 in the ratio minus Y1 is to Y2. Now how to prove this formula? First draw a diagram related to the given data. Suppose this is X-axis. Suppose this is the point A, X1, Y1. This is the point B, whose coordinates are X2, Y2. This is the line joining of the points A and B. Now, what is your statement? X-axis divides line joining the points A, X1, Y1 and B, X2, Y2 in the ratio minus Y1 is to Y2. Now in the diagram, this is the intersecting point of x-axis and the line AB. Now take this intersecting point as P. From the diagram, the ratio in which x-axis divides AB is same as the ratio in which P divides AB. See once again, the ratio in which x-axis divides AB is the same as the ratio in which P point divides AB. Suppose the point P divides AB in the ratio m is to n. It means distance from A to P is m units, distance from P to B is n units. Here, what is my assumption? Let the point P divides AB in the ratio m is to n. From the diagram, the point P divides AB in the ratio m is to n internally. So, from the section formula, P point coordinates can be taken as P equals to mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. Here the point P divides AB in the ratio m is to n internally. So from internal division formula, P point coordinates can be taken as mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. If you look at the diagram, this point P lies on x-axis. So what is its y-coordinate value? 0. So, you can equating y coordinate of the point P to 0. So, P lies on x axis. Since P lies on x axis, this implies y coordinate of P, y coordinate of P equals to 0. What is the y coordinate of P? My2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n equal to 0. On cross multiplication, my2 plus ny1 equal to 0. From this, my2 equal to minus ny1. From this, m divided by n equals to minus y1 divided by y2. So, therefore, m is to n is equals to minus y1 is to y2. That is our required ratio. So, what is the statement of this formula? X-axis divides the line joining the points AX1, Y1 and BX2, Y2 in the ratio minus Y1 is to Y2. Now come to another formula. Y-axis divides the line joining the points AX1 Y1 and BX2 Y2 in the ratio minus X1 is to X2. What is the statement? Y-axis divides the line joining the points AX1 Y1 and BX2 Y2 in the ratio minus X1 is to X2. Now how to prove this formula? First, draw a diagram related to given data. Suppose this is y-axis. This is the point A whose coordinates are x1, y1. Suppose this is the point P, coordinates are x2, y2. This is the line passing through the points A and B. Now in the diagram, this is the intersecting point of line AB and y-axis. Now take this point as a P. So from the diagram, the ratio in which y-axis divides AB is the same as the ratio in which P divides AB. See once again, the ratio in which y-axis divides AB is the same as the ratio in which P divides AB. Initially, we don't know the ratio. Take that ratio as m is to n. Suppose the point P divides AB in the ratio M is to N. It means distance from A to P is M units, distance from P to B is N units. What is your assumption? Let P divides AB in the ratio M is to N. So this length is M, this length is N. From the diagram, the point P divides AB in the ratio M is to N internally. P divides AB in the ratio M is to N internally. So apply internal division formula. So from the diagram, P point coordinates can be taken as P equal to mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. If you observe the diagram, this point P lies on y-axis. So its x-coordinate value is 0. So equating x-coordinate of P to 0. So since the point P lies on y-axis, so implies x-coordinate of P is 0. So equating this x-coordinate value to 0. So from this, mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n equal to 0. On cross multiplication, mx2 plus nx1 equals to 0. So from this, mx2 equal to minus nx1. M divided by n equals to minus x1 divided by x2. Therefore, m is to n is equals to minus x1 is to x2. Now, what is the formula? Y-axis divides line joining of the points AX1, Y1 and BX2, Y2 in the ratio minus x1 is to x2. Now, come to the problem. Find the ratio in which the line joining the points 4, 2 and minus 7, minus 5 is divided by the x-axis. Now, what is the ratio of the line joining the points x1, y1 and x2, y2 is divided by the x-axis? That ratio will be minus y1 is to y2. X-axis divides the line joining of the points x1, y1 and x2, y2 in the ratio minus y1 is to y2. Now use that formula. What are the given points? 4, 2 and minus 7, minus 5. Let x1, y1 equals to 4, 2. x2, y2 equals to minus 7, minus 5. Required ratio equals to minus y1 is to y2. What is the formula? The ratio in which x-axis divides line joining of the points x1, y1 and x2, y2 is minus y1 is to y2. Now substitute the corresponding values. Minus y1. What is your y1 value? 2. Is to y2. What is the value of y2? Minus 5. So this equal to 2 is to 5. So required ratio is 2 is to 5. Now come to the next problem. Find the ratio in which the line joining the points 3, minus 4 and minus 4, minus 5 is divided by the y-axis. What is the corresponding formula? The ratio in which y-axis divides line joining of the points x1, y1 and x2, y2 is minus x1 is to x2. So, the ratio in which y-axis divides line joining of the points x1 y1 and x2 y2 is minus x1 is to x2. So use that formula. What are the given points? 3 comma minus 4 and minus 4 comma minus 5. Let x1 y1 equals to 3 comma minus 4. X2 y2 equals to minus 4 comma minus 5. Required ratio equals to minus x1 is to x2. Now this equal to minus x1. What is the value of x1? 3 is to x2. X2 value minus 4. So this equal to 3 is to 4. So therefore y-axis divides the line joining of the points 3 comma minus 4 and minus 4 comma minus 5 in the ratio 3 is to 4. Now come to the next problem. Find the ratio in which the point P divides the line joining of the points A and B. Now first draw a diagram related to given data. Suppose this is the line passing through the points A and B. Now take a point P on this line AB. Suppose here P is a point on the line AB. Now A point coordinates are given as 8, 9. B point coordinates are minus 7, 4. P point coordinates are 2, 7. So here what is the required one? Find the ratio in which the point P divides line joining of the points A and B. Suppose the point P divides AB in the ratio M is to N. What is our assumption? Suppose the point P divides AB in the ratio M is to N. It means distance from A to P is M. Distance from P to B is N. Then use section formula for internal division. Because in our assumption, P point divides AB in the ratio M is to N internally from the diagram. So use section formula. So P point coordinates can be taken as MX2 plus NX1 divided by M plus N, MY2 plus NY1 divided by M plus N. P point coordinates are 2 comma 7 equals to M into X2. Now here A point coordinates can be taken as X1, Y1. B point coordinates are X2, Y2. Now substitute the corresponding values in this formula. M into X2, that is minus 7 plus N into X1, 8 divided by M plus N. Next, M into Y2. What is the value of Y2? 4. Plus N into Y1. That is 9 divided by M plus N. Now, it is 2 comma 7 equals to minus 7M plus 8N divided by M plus N. This is 4M plus 9N divided by M plus N. Now equating the x coordinates is 2 equals to minus 7M plus 8N divided by M plus N. Now do the cross multiplication. It is 2M plus 2N equals to minus 7M plus 8N. Bring this minus 7M from RHS to LHS. 2M plus 7M, 9M equals to, bring this 2N term from LHS to RHS. 8N minus 2N, that is 6N. Now see the cancellation. Cancellation with 3, 3 into 3, that is 9. So 3 will be cancelled in 9, 3 times. 3 will be cancelled in 6 2 times. It is 3m equals to 2n. So m divided by n is equals to 2 divided by 3. Therefore, m is to n is equal to 2 is to 3. It means the point P divides AB in the ratio 2 is to 3 internally. So write down the conclusion. P divides AB in the ratio 2 is to 3 internally.